Hey family, what's going on? Klaus here, and welcome back to our Channel 7 Let's Play, where guys, as usual, four builders in a laboratory available. Guys, it's going by very quickly. Obviously, with the new Title 14 update, things are quicker and shorter and cheaper and all that stuff. So, what that means is that we're going to knock out an upgrade today. A bunch of them, actually. One of them being a laboratory upgrade, and we're going to start with it, because I have max elixir in my storage. I got loads of it in the treasury, so that means that we need to go ahead and get something going. I'm using hog riders, which means that I'm specifically using hogs with wizards with archers, and I need to upgrade the wizards and the archers for the CC kill, just in case there is one. So that's obviously my next priority. I need to upgrade these wizards to level 4. It's only a day and a half upgrade, and it's only 650,000 elixir, which is not too bad. So let's do it. 650,000 elixir. 3, 2, 1, bam. Alright, so, like I said, I've got loads of loot in the treasury. I have no other way to spend elixir. I mean, I can upgrade gold mines like I mentioned last time, and every time before that. But I'm not going to spend my builders like that right now. Let's go into my progress base, because I do want to have a look-see at the defenses. And, as you can see, there they are there. I'm going to work on my cannons today, because they all need to be upgraded twice. So, these two being level 6 is bothering me. Let's just be honest, it's bothering me. So, let's go and upgrade two of these right now to level 7. This is 200,000 gold twice. 3, 2, 1, bam. 3, 2, 1, bam. Alright then, there we go. So, now, if I remember correctly, let me see, hold on. Nope, I have not maxed out a single mortar yet. But my guess is level 5 is maxed out. And the reason why is because the mortars and the air defenses sort of usually follow the same upgrade pattern. So if you got a level 5 air defense, probably you have a level 5 mortar. That's at least true for the lower levels of the game. So that means that my next couple of upgrades will probably be mortars. I don't know. But first things first, obviously we have to go do some raids. By the way, if you guys are new to the channel, please do not forget to like, subscribe, join the Klaus family for daily gaming videos. And also do not panic. Yes, I know I've got over max dark elixir. That's because I have no way to spend it. That's why I'm using hogs, because they're powerful, because I don't need the dark elixir, and because they're fun to use. So there's a bunch of reasons why I'm using hogs. So let's go find a base and tear it up. We really don't need loot, so I'm just going to attack a base that looks fun. Alright, I'm just going to attack a base, like, I could attack a Town Hall 6. That would be fun, because it's fun to bully bases, but at the same time, it's not fun at all, you know. So let me try to find a base that looks, you know, entertaining at least. It'd be cool if we found, like, a rush Town Hall 9 or something. That'd be super cool. Okay, that's actually a pretty strong Town Hall 7. Let's take this one out. 32 trophies. Not bad. And we do have a possible clan castle. This is level 2 clan. Don't judge a book by its cover, but generally speaking, these lower level clans probably won't have CC troops. Again, it may not be true. We'll find out. So let's send in a hog, and they have a dragon. Great. Okay. Unexpected, but that's cool. I like that. So let's send in an archer. We're going to enrapture. Okay, that's a word I'm making up. I don't think that's the actual term, but we're going to enwrap, maybe that's the right word, the dragon in troops. But first I'm going to distract them with the king. So let's send them in. There we go. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. All right, dragon, you ain't got nothing, son. You ain't got nothing. All right, so now that that dragon is dead, goodbye Smaug. Let's send in the hogs. All right, and I've got some max CC hogs too, or not max, but you know, strong ones. And so I'm gonna send them in kind of in front to kind of distract from the wizard tower, and just to kind of cut off the rest of the hogs, that way they stay on task. Problem, enemy king is in the way. I'm gonna drop another heal. I'm gonna get an early heal. I think there's probably double giant bomb there, or at least a single giant bomb, so I'm gonna try my best to not deploy another heal spell until I need to. Actually, look at that. Look at the wizards getting rid of that air defense for me. Good job. All right, I'm going to go and drop the heal, because they're not going to have to come across that anymore. There was a Tesla there. That was not a giant bomb. There was a Tesla. Or there could be both. Hold on. Let me look. No giant bomb. Where are the giant bombs? That is super weird, man. They're probably on the outside. Watch this group of hogs. Watch this group of hogs. They're probably about to expose a giant bomb. If they don't, yeah, there it is right there. See, there's no way to predict that. I don't know what to do. I just know that my king can survive that. So I'm definitely gonna 3-star. It's a matter of time. It's a question thing as to whether or not we'll actually be able to 3-star it in a decent amount of time. But there we go, there's hogs, easy stuff. Just keep the heal, keep them on the heal. The thing that was profound and was spoken to me whenever I first started playing Clash was, you can't heal dead hogs. And what that was meant to tell me was, keep your hogs alive early. Don't worry about them so much during the middle of the raid. Well, let me reiterate. Keep them alive at the beginning. Make sure they make it through the middle. And then be sparingly with that third one, okay? Just make sure that your hogs survive until the back end of the attack. And you get a really good feel for that as you play. So there we go, guys. There's the 3-star, 32 trophies, easy money. And we got a star bonus. That's awesome, too. So I'm going to request for some hogs. And in the meantime, and I'm also waiting for the king to wake up. Where's king? Yeah, he's got up 2 minutes to go. So in the meantime, I'm going to go to my my builder base because I am, as you can see, I'm about 60, 80,000 elixir away from upgrading my battle machine to level 7, which you guys know 7 is my favorite number. So let's go do a raid. I think I've got, as long as I win one, hopefully I'll win one today. I'm willing to give it more than one try, though. I normally don't try more than once, but I'm willing to try more than once today because I do want to get this this battle machine going. So kind of started with a big, nice open spread. This base is very open concept, which is cool, but it's also annoying. It's kind of tough to take these bases out. So, there we go. Oh boy, this is gonna be rough. There's a firecracker over there too, so let's get this baby dragon going over here. The problem with these guard post troops, man, is they distract and they slow things down so much. It's so annoying. All right, battle machine, you get in there. You're gonna do some work. You're gonna do lots of good work. Firecracker, air bomb, it looks like, there we go, it goes down, this baby dragon's gonna be able to turn and take that out. Come on, buddy. Alright. Tesla, an archer tower, and I've got one more baby dragon, and that's gonna be settled on this firecracker here in just a moment. So, there goes the air bomb, this baby dragon should survive and get a little bit of damage on the firecracker. In fact, there we go, it goes down, 3-star, perfect. Let's get this baby dragon out here on this builder hall, and that's gonna be the 3-star. So now it's a matter of time, right? Let's see if the other guy 3-star is faster than I do. We'll find out. But yeah, level 12 baby dragons are not too shabby, are they? I love it, actually. I really, really love it. Level 7 battle machine. I don't know if it makes a big difference, but getting to level 10 is a big deal. Because remember, we're trying to get that 6th builder as soon as possible. And I think the battle machine has to go to level 20? 25? Something like that? I don't even know. So, something to consider. Something to continue to work on. And they beat me by 18 seconds. Fabulous. All right, like I said, I'm going to try again. I'm dedicated to getting this level 7 battle machine today. As you guys can tell on my actual main base, I don't have any issue with loot. It's a matter of time. It's about a matter of keeping my builders working. So I can kind of spend a little bit more time focused on builder base, which is fun. All right, so let's keep these up. I think this guy's about to go to the other army camp. Nope, he's going for the air bomb. Nice, good job, baby dragon. Didn't do much good, but you know, hey, it's cool. Hopefully, yeah, these two are gonna come in. It's gonna distract the air bomb now, and now let's start taking it out. There we go. Very good. Battle machine, I want you to get in there and start distracting some troops, and stupid guard post troops are the worst. Get another one up in here. There we go. Stupid guard post is still ruining everything. Ooh, ooh, get it. Yes. Yes. Okay. This is looking good. So, let's get this archer tower down. Baby dragon doing a great job here. I don't know, though, if this is a winning combination. I'm not sure if we're going to be able to get that 3-star. And if this is the case, then we may have to settle for a high percent 1-star. I'm not sure. Let's get the baby dragon in on the roaster and... Yeah, I don't know, because I think the baby dragon will go to the guard post and then might go to the builder hall, but it's not going to be able to keep up. This firecracker is doing too much damage. So that's going to be it. All right, so high percent 1-star. Hopefully the other guy got a lower percent 1-star or a 0-star. That'd be awesome. Odds are not likely. Let's see what happens. Oh, wow. 3-star. Okay, I'm going to give it one more try. Okay, I need to win. I just need to win once. Okay, let's give it one more try. If I don't win this, then fine. I'll just take care of it and maybe upgrade the battle machine off camera. Remember, this is not a builder-based Let's Play. It is just kind of keeping you guys in the know on how much progress you can probably make on your own base if you stay relatively dedicated. I've kind of slipped a little bit lately because of the Tunnel 14 update, but getting back into it, I would say. So, get in there on air bomb. Come on. Let's go. Come on. Yeah. Oh, look at that. Look at this baby dragon. Look at this baby dragon. Didn't take a single shot from that air bomb. That was legit right there. That was amazing. All right, double cannon. Let's get the battle machine in here. And firecracker go down. Actually, I could probably just kind of like YOLO everybody in now. I think I've got this 3-star. So, there we go. Awesome. That's actually pretty quick. It's going to be a less than 60-second 3-star too, I think. Pop that ability, and that'll be it. Unless I missed a bit. Nope. Okay. I got everybody. I got everything. We're good. All right. That was better. That was way, way better. Because we got rid of the air bomb super quickly, right? That was awesome. So, and we won. And he got a 65% 1-star. Why couldn't I have gotten that? Got that 65. I would have beat that with the last raid, right? If you look at the battle log, I got a 74%. Why couldn't I have gotten that last time? Anyway, so we won. Okay. Sweet. So I get to finally upgrade this battle machine. Going to level 7. 1.6 million elixir. One day upgrade in 3, 2, 1. Bam. Nice. All right. And I'm going to go ahead and boost the clock tower. Laboratory, I'm not really doing anything with. I'm saving my elixir from my battle machine. So that'll do. Awesome. So let's go bounce back over to here. I got no CC troops, which is fine. Let's do it again with no CC this time. I think I can probably still pull off a 3-star, especially if I choose a base that's not like super tough. But again, I'm not going to dip. All right. I'm going to play around. I'm going to have some fun with it. And I want to get a base that has a fair amount of trophies for me. Okay. That's my goal. So more than 30 would be great. Come on. Ooh, Town Hall 8. Yeah, not going to do that. I could probably do it. You guys have seen me take on Town Hall 8s before, but I'm kind of looking for the safer 3-stars right now without a clan castle or a dead base. The dead base with tons of loot would be kind of cool too. 27 trophies. I'm going to skip that. It looked good, but it wasn't it. So a little bit of patience goes a long way. I often get criticized on YouTube in the comments of people that are like, dude, just pick a base and attack. And it's like, okay, sure, if you want to watch me fail, then I'll go ahead and rush and just attack the first base I run into. You guys know, if you actually play Clash of Clans, if you actually play, then you know better. You know that you don't just attack willy-nilly. You gotta attack what you need to attack, what you should attack. So anyway, you guys know better. That's why it's mostly the trolls. We don't care about the trolls. Don't be a troll. Anyway, so let's go. Let's see if there's a CC. Another dragon! Oh my goodness. Why? Why is there dragons? Flippin' Smaug. Alright, let's get this out of here. I guess I'm gonna have to use my king again. That severely reduces the odds of a 3-star. Just a heads up. Alright, get that in there. A couple of wizards and a few archers. I'm not gonna use all of them because I'm pretty confident that I can 3-star this. Oh wow. Okay, well, king's ability. This dragon's kind of beastly. More beastly than the last one, for sure. There we go, it went down. Nice. Alright, so, hogs, stay ahead. Okay, stay ahead. Let's get a archer on the corner building, and now I'm watching for... Yeah, we gotta get a heal in there. I'm watching for giant bombs and other splash damage right now. Wow, this is a weird attack. I'm actually seeing a possible... Yeah, all right, let's drop a heal out here. We want to keep these hogs alive. Hopefully I didn't lose any right there to that delayed heal spell. But because I was able to kind of keep things kind of even and spread them out, I prioritized one group and the other ones were kind of like the sacrificial lamb, you know? And they got a lot of value for not really having to use a heal spell on them. And then I kept the real group alive and they're the ones that are going to wrap it up. So that worked out nicely. So now it's kind of a matter of time. I think we got the 3-star because I think we got both of the giant bombs. I don't think there's three. There's definitely two that I'm remembering. So there was another 3-star. Nice. No CC. Stupid dragon in the CC. We got it. So that was awesome. These hogs will, I guess, go down first. Oh, no. There we go. That gold storage is gone. So definitely going to go up. And everything should finish up on the gold mines. And then, yeah, there's a couple of builder huts in the corners. These two down here, or the one that was down here is gone. So it's going to be, I would say, probably the top one and then the one on the left, if I had to make a guess. So, yeah, there it is. And none of them are going to the left. Look at that. Unless some of these wizards try. No. Yeah. Dang it. It's all about the stupid... wait, right? It's always because I had to use my archers. I didn't want to have to use my archers on the stupid dragon. I wanted to take out the corner buildings with that, but you know, CC, taking out the CC is obviously the number one priority. So there we go. 3-star once again, and decent amount of loot. 29 more trophies. Not going to complain about that. There we go. All right, so now that we've done all that, guys, let's do a couple of mortar upgrades. I'm trying to work on them, get them done, get them over with, get them across that progress base, all right? Get them out of there. So two-day upgrade, 500,000 gold in 3, 2, 1, bam. And of course, I'll do this one as well. And there we go, guys. Let's actually place these down. I don't know where. Just put one of them there, I guess, and put the other one somewhere else. Kind of keep them all in the same cluster, I guess. Let's move this mortar out of the way. There we go. Alright, so by tonight, my cannons will be done. I'll be working on cannons, but I'm gonna finish the mortars. Obviously, the splash damage from the mortar is more dangerous to the hog riders than the single targeting cannons. So I'm gonna work on the mortars, prioritize them. Then, of course, we still have this giant bomb that I think is maxed out. Yep, because we upgraded it, I think, last episode. So let's put this over with the other one. There we go. I've got some extra loot in the loot cart. So yeah, I've got no problem with loot. And I guess these little bombs are probably going to need to be the priority going forward. Just because, again, they do a lot more damage. And of course, the spring trap upgrade too, which doesn't really change anything for hogs. Because their troop capacity is divisible by 5. So increasing a spring trap from 10 to 12 does not change anything about hogs. It will help with wizards, like I've said. So, you know, we'll definitely work on spring traps. But we're very close to being done with defenses and traps. A couple of episodes and that's it. So then the question is, do we need to collect his mines? I'm thinking, here's what we'll do. I'm thinking I'm going to finish the defenses, continue to work on laboratory upgrades. I've still got like 5 or 6 left after this. So I'll continue to work on laboratory upgrades every episode, as well as upgrading collectors and mines once we get to that point. And then I'll upgrade the town hall, do the collectors and mines off camera if there's any left, and we'll move on to town hall 8. That's my plan. Let me know in the comments what you guys think about all that. And there we go. Making it happen. Still, battle machine. I always try to say builder hall. It's not the same thing. Battle Machine level 7. That's exciting. That's all for me for today. Thank you all so much for tuning in. Like this video if you liked it and subscribe if you haven't already for daily gaming videos. Don't forget to ring the bell for notifications and do not forget to use code Klaus, which is super helpful because he gives a small percentage of every purchase to the content creator you choose to support. So if you choose to support me, thank you so much for doing so. Just remember though, if you go into your shop, look for Little White C. It's there, which means we're good. But if it is not there anymore, that means it has expired. It does expire after 7 days. So go into your shop. Look for that white C. If it's not there, use the link in the description to input the code or do it manually in your settings. Guys, that's all for me. Remember that I love each and every one of you, and I will see you all again next time.